Hello everyone, welcome to BizOrTech. In our last video, we discussed about concepts based on allegations and mixtures. In this video, we will be discussing problems on the same. So let's begin with the first problem. A container contains 40 liters of milk. From this container, 4 liters of milk was taken out and replaced by water. This process was repeated further 2 times. How much milk is now contained by the container? So it's a very well elaborated question. So you have a container in which 40 liters milk was there, in which 4 liters was taken off and poured by water. This was repeated for 3 times. When this was happening, so now what is the milk which is left out in the container? And you have options for that. So it cannot be like they took out 12 liters and then poured water. So 28 liters is the water. So that cannot be possible, because every time when they take out milk, they used to pour water. So this cannot be the answer. You can directly eliminate it. Anyways, let's concentrate on the solution part now. So now, in order to explain the solution, I would like to recall the second method we learned in the concept. And the concept says, suppose a container contains X units of liquid from which Y units are taken out and replaced by water or any other liquid. After the n operations, quantity of pure liquid is given by the following formula, where x is the container quantity and y is replaced quantity and n is the total number of times the process has been repeated. And now, milk contained by the container now is equal to 40 into 1 minus 4 by 40 whole power 3. I am just substituting it, and 4, 1, 4, 10, 1 minus 1 by 10 whole power 3. And now just subtract this, so 10 minus 1 9, 9 by 10, so 40 into 9 by 10 whole power 3, and that can be written as 40 into 9 by 10 into 9 by 10 into 9 by 10, so 0 0 will go off, and that will finally give us 4 into 9 into 9 into 9 divided by 100, which is equal to 29.16 liters. So this is a normal calculation, so that gives you the right answer option, 29.16 liters. So this is been solved by the second method, dilution method. So I hope this is clear for you. So now let's move on to the second problem. In 1 kg mixture of iron and manganese, 20% is manganese. How much iron should be added so that the proportion of manganese becomes 10%? So in 1 kg of mixture, both iron and manganese are there, so 20% is the concentration of the manganese. So in order to make this manganese concentration to 10%, how much iron should be added? So it's like one weave question, like when you see it in one side, you will be able to get it. It will be definitely 10%. So, but they have asked you in proportion. So let's see, let's look at the options. 1.5 kg, 2 kg, 5 and 1 kg. By this time, I hope you already know the answer. But anyways, let's go through solution method. So this will be solved by the rule of allegation. So the rule of allegation says, this will be the cheaper quantity or this will be the dearer cost price. So you can just interchange, no problem. This will be mean price. This is mean price minus dearer, mean price minus cheaper. So this will be the formula setup and you will get this. So percentage concentration of manganese in the mixture, 20. Here you can't write 20% because we are doing it through proportion ratios method. So percentage of concentration was 20, and then iron concentration, whether iron and manganese were mixed, no, the iron concentration was 0, and percentage concentration of manganese is the final mixture. This is the required, so that will be the final one, 10. Now very simple, so 10 minus 0, 10. Here it should be always greater minus smaller, because ratio cannot be negative. So 20 minus 10, 10. So both the case it will be same thing. So 10 is to 10. So 10 is to 10, this is the ratio. This is the quantity which is being given in ratio. So 10 is to 10 is nothing but 1 is to 1. So 1 part of manganese will have 1 part of iron. So that will give us the required answer, 1 kg. Hence the quantity of iron to be added is equal to 1 kg. Answer option D, 1 kg. Now let's move on to question number 3. and it says tea worth rupees 126 per kg and rupees 135 per kg are mixed with a third variety of tea in the ratio 1:1. If the mixture is worth rupees 153 per kg, what is the price of the third variety per kg? Here, what you need to understand is the question is not pretty direct as you feel. It's like 126 per kg and 135 per kg are mixed to get 153 per kg. That's not how it's working. So concentrate on this keenly so that when you see this, tea worth rupees 126 per kg and 135 per kg are mixed with the third variety. So that means it's a compound mixture problem. So you have a variety 126 and you have one more variety 135 and they forms a mixture. And that variety we will find out with the help of this. And then that is mixed with one more variety which we don't know, which is X. And then the mean price will be 153. So in order to do this, let me just take you through solutions. Before that, you have four options given for this. So let's start with the solution. So both of them are mixed in the ratio 1:1. So then the average price will be 130.5. How? 126 plus 135 divided by 2, 130.5. So this price is mixed with one more quantity X, which we will find out by allegation method. And the mean is given by 153. So let's go to allegation method directly. By the rule of allegation, cost of 1 kg of first kind of tea is 130.50. And then the next kind of tea we have to calculate, but we know the mean price as 153. And this we will get by X minus 153, and 153 minus 130.50, you will have 22.50. So now equated. So how to equate? So X is to 22.50 is equal to 1:1. So they are mixed in the quantity 1:1. So here there is no much calculation required because the mixtures are in equal proportion. So X minus 153 will be equal to 22.5. So X is equal to 22.50 plus 153, which will give us the price of the third quantity, which is 175.5. So in turn giving you the right answer option C. So I hope this is clear. And now let's move on to question number 4. The cost of one type of material is rupees 15 per kg and type 2 material is 20 per kg if both type 1 and type 2 are mixed in the ratio 2:3. So now this is a direct question. So both of them are mixed. And here what you need to concentrate is rupees is not given, ratio is given. So what's missing? Mean itself is missing. And how do we find out that? By allegation method. So before that, you have four options and let's see how to get the solution. First, so cost price of first material 15, then 20, and mean we don't know, so let's keep it as X. By allegation method, it's 15, 20, but without knowing mean, we will take it as X. And we know these ratios, they are mixed in the ratio 2:3. So if you calculate this, 20 minus X and X minus 15. And now this 20 minus X and X minus 15, this will be equated to the mixture, which is 2:3. So 20 minus X is 2, X minus 13 is equal to 2:3. And now very simple. So 20 minus X divided by X minus 15 is equal to 2/3. I'm just writing the ratios in division form and now multiplying that. So what you will get? 3 into 20 minus X is equal to 2 into X minus 20, which in turn 60 minus 3X is equal to 2X minus 50. So that will give you 5X is equal to 19 and X is equal to 18. So 18 will be the price of the. And there is one more way of solving this question, and that method is called as option elimination method. And this doesn't work for all the problems. So anyways, for this problem, we'll see how it works. We know that both this 15 per kg and 20 per kg are mixed in the ratio 2:3. So when we mix it, we should get that ratio. So 20 minus 19, so it will be 1, and 19 minus 15, 4. So that's not a right ratio. So eliminate 19. Next, 20 minus 16, 4. Then 15 minus, again, 4 is to 1, not a right one. Now take 18. 20 minus 18, 2. 18 minus 15, 3. 2 is to 3 ratio. So the right answer should be 18. So this is the way where you can solve rather than normal method, so that you will save a lot of time. So apart from that, you will have normal method as well, by which we solved and got the answer as 18. So now let's move on to the last problem of this video. Find the ratio in which rice at 7.20 rupees a kg be mixed with rice at 5.70 rupees a kg to produce mixture worth of 6.30 a kg. What we should calculate, in what ratio they have mixed. So very simple. So we will have a normal method being followed for this. So let's have our allegation method. So first kind 7.20, second kind 5.70, and mean 6.30. So let's apply the rule of allegation. You have everything ready, and now subtract it. 6.3 minus 5.7 will give you 0.6, and here 7.2 minus 6.3, 0.9. So just make sure that this doesn't come in negative, because ratio cannot be negative. So now they are in the ratio 0.6 is to 0.9, which is nothing but 6 is to 9. You can just take it 60 and 90, and then just to make calculation easier, 6 is to 3. So 3, 2s are 3s are. So 2 is to 3. This is also right, but we are converting this with regard to the options which are available. So I hope this is clear. And in our next video, we will solve some more problems on allegations and mixtures. Thank you so much for watching.